Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. The Arctic blast has been impacting millions of U.S. residents from coast to coast, and there's more wicked weather to come.
Nearly 80% of the U.S. are bracing for below freezing temperatures over the week as another Arctic blast is set to hit the northeast this weekend, and more storms are expected in the west. At least 75,000 people were without power in Oregon on Wednesday, as the Pacific Northwest has been hit by heavy rain and snow since Tuesday night. It is the first in a set of storms to follow. Oregon and Washington are expected to experience anywhere from 24 to 48 inches of snow. Record-breaking freezing temperatures have already been set across Texas, Oklahoma, and Kansas. Hard freeze warnings are expected for many parts of the Gulf Coast, including Texas and Florida. Below freezing temps are also hitting Memphis, Dallas, and Nashville. Enough snow has already fallen to snap the snow drought in Washington, D.C., Baltimore, Philadelphia, and New York City, leading to slippery roads. Gabriel Young, a PhilAm who works in Washington, D.C., says to stay safe, he didn't leave his apartment.
Roads have been noted to being slippery with black ice everywhere, and telling folks to limit driving as well. So for my own safety precautions, I followed whatever I was told, barely left my apartment complex today, and did my best to work from home and stay productive.
Let's go to Chicago, where below freezing temperatures are causing great concern for those experiencing homelessness.
PhilAm Emmanuel Pobustan has been homeless for 5 years now. While Illinois has provided warming stations for the homeless, there are limitations.
You line up outside at 8 o'clock, they let you in at 9 o'clock, and they kick you out at 5 a.m. That's the problem.
According to the Illinois Department of Human Services, over 10,000 people are living in shelters, parks, abandoned buildings, cars, or barns. The 50-year-old Pobustan says he's not only worried about where he is going to sleep every night, but he also has his health struggles. Despite all these, he remains grateful.
Thank God I'm still alive. Both of my legs still swollen. But amen to all the people that helped me and give me money when I panhandle.
Still in Chicago, Filipino NBA fans came in droves to witness the face-off between the Chicago Bulls and the Houston Rockets while celebrating Filipino Heritage Night.
Chicago's United Center is known as the home of the Chicago Bulls, but PhilAm fans were also rooting for one particular player from the visiting Houston Rockets, PhilAm Jalen Green.
Woo! Just for him, but I'm rooting for the Bulls, of course.
The 21-year-old shooting guard had a stellar rookie season, finishing with all rookie team honors. What made the night more special was that the Bulls hosted Filipino Heritage Night.
It's pretty remarkable that an organization such as the Chicago Bulls takes the time to put out and get a free hat and actually promote the Filipino culture.
It was a close game that went to overtime. Green scored 18 points, but the Rockets were no match for the Bulls. Chicago's Kobe White scored 30 points to lead the home team to a 124-119 win. Despite the loss, Green was in good spirits, knowing that Filipinos had a great night.
Filipino Heritage Night, everybody's cool. You know, all the Filipino fans come out, show love and support.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
The U.S. government relists Yemen's Houthi rebels as terrorists. The White House announced the group's return as a specially designated global terrorist was aimed at cutting off funding and weapons for the rebels. This is meant to stem their attacks on international shipping in the Red Sea. The White House also issued so-called carve-outs aimed at avoiding an impact on Yemen's population, which relies on food imports and humanitarian aid.
Since November, the Houthis have launched numerous missiles and drones towards international merchant ships, as well as U.S. and partner naval vessels defending the safety and security of commercial shipping across the Red Sea. These attacks against international shipping have endangered mariners and disrupted the free flow of commerce and freedom of navigation. For the past several weeks, the United States, with allies and partners around the world, has made clear that there must be consequences for those attacks. And today's designation follows on our military action last week to hold the Houthis accountable for their actions.
Aid destined for Israeli hostages and Palestinian civilians in the Gaza Strip, now in Egypt for transfer across the border. One of the planes was carrying medical packages for 45 Israeli hostages. Meanwhile, Qatar said supplies for Palestinian civilians would be distributed to parts of Gaza that are most affected by the conflict. Israel began letting aid into Gaza on October 21st. But agencies warned the amount of supplies delivered falls far short for what's needed for Gaza's 2.3 million population. More people in Gaza are likely to die from hunger than from the war. That's according to Palestine Investment Fund Chairman Mohamed Mostafa. Speaking at the World Economic Forum in Davos, Mostafa said the international community needs to move quickly to avert such a scenario. He adds establishing an independent Palestinian state is necessary to end the conflict.
I think the political solution is a must now. I don't think one can avoid but see the facts. And the facts are that military solutions will not solve the problem. Occupation cannot continue. No people will accept to be oppressed the way Palestinians have been oppressed. So it's time to go to the root problem. And the root problem is occupation. We need to end the Israeli occupation to the Palestinian, all Palestinians, not only in Gaza, but also in the West Bank and East Jerusalem, and allow Palestinians to build their own sovereign, independent state.
Mostafa also says at least $15 billion is needed to rebuild homes in the Gaza Strip. Israel's war has turned much of the Palestinian territory into a wasteland, killing more than 24,000 people and wounding nearly 61,000 more.